going on, ViJaGamers? It's the ViJaPlayer here, and today I have a little treat for you. It is the Black Hammer. It is the new raid sniper rifle, and this thing, it's a beast, but let's get it started with the perks. I'm going to talk about all that stuff a little bit later. As you can tell, it is a solar damage weapon. We're going to get it started with these first initial scopes, because that's basically the only reason why you're going to want to change these out, but honestly, I wouldn't change any of them out. I would keep it. I'd keep the first one there because all they do is mess with the stability and the reload, which really sucks. Now the first special perk, White Nail, rapidly landing 3 precision shots will refill the magazine, which is it's helpful in PvE situations and PvP, not so much, but it doesn't really matter. Okay, so here we are. Here's snapshot. Aiming this weapon is incredibly fast. Obviously, somewhat useful. Not the most useful. Flared Magwell, way more useful of a perk. I mean, look at the reload. It's like it maxes the reload out and then perfect balance, which is what I would highly suggest. I'm going to take it off for a second to show you guys what the stability looks like. And look at it. It goes down so low. And the stability, it's bad when if you don't have that perk on. But here we go. Mulligan. Missing a shot has a chance to return ammo directly to the magazine. You're going to need that with a three magazine. I don't know. But here we go. Hive Disruptor, which is the special raid perk. Increased damage to Hive Majors, which unlike the old raid weapons, that raid perk could actually come in handy in a lot of different situations. All right, now before going to the gameplay, I'm actually going to do something a little different. The Rate of Fire on this thing, it's so small and minuscule. There's nothing. And then the impact is more than like the icebreaker. The range is almost maxed out. The stability's not the best. And I'm showing you what it is. Basically, the base, the stability and the reload. The reload's pretty good. It's not that bad. The stability, though, when you're aiming that thing down, you want to be as stable as possible, and that's why I use that. But I was showing you guys the last little part, was the magazine. The magazine is, it's three. There's three bullets in the magazine. And that's the most frustrating part about this. You know, I could deal with this. I could deal with the stability. I can deal with everything else. But it's the magazine. But you know what? After taking this gun into a game of the Iron Banner, I'm playing the Iron Banner right now. After taking it into a game of that, I'm not sure if it does it on regular PvP, but, like, literally, you guys, you shoot an enemy anywhere in the body, it doesn't even have to be the head, anywhere, and the guy's almost dead, like, literally, like, almost dead, like, a little tiny sliver of health is left. So, I mean, this gun is extremely powerful. If your enemy is somewhat damaged, he is dead. He's out. He's done for. So that's why I'm going to have to tell you guys that this gun is good. This gun's a beast, honestly. Like, the critical hits hit more than the icebreaker, and that seemed to be, like, everybody's favorite weapon, and the stability on it is better than the icebreaker. The only bad thing about it is, like I was talking about, the magazine. Oh, the magazine. It was so, like, I almost wasn't even going to play with this gun, like, just because of that. Like, I didn't even see any other stats on the gun or see any other anything on the gun. All I saw was the magazine size. I was like, three? Psh, this gun's gonna suck. And on top of being sexy in the three rounds in the clip, this gun still is a beast. And you guys will see in this gameplay, I get a double relentless, I want to say. I go on a 10 kill streak twice, basically, mainly using this, you know, not only. Yeah, it's definitely a relentless, but yeah, I go on 2 10 kill streaks in this game. I go completely off with this sniper rifle, as you guys have been seeing for this time, or for this this gameplay. Definitely pay attention to the gameplay. I mean, I tried really hard. I went all out, and I might not always be using the Black Hammer, but it's definitely going to show you guys how powerful this gun is. It's amazing, and you know, the rate of fire on the gun is It's just atrocious. I mean, that's another thing that I actually, that's actually another downside of the gun that I forgot to mention before. The rate of fire is absolutely horrible. If you miss the headshot, or if you don't kill whoever you are, I would suggest switching over to a different weapon, because that seems to be faster than to wait to be able to pull the trigger again, because of how slow the rate of fire is on this gun. But like I was telling you guys, I mean, it's just an amazing gun. Like, you guys need to grind out the new raid. You guys definitely don't want to miss out on this. I mean, does extra damage to hive majors and ultras. I mean, that's perfect for nightfalls and stuff, you know? So all in all, out of all the negative things you could say about this gun, I'd say take it into PvP, you know, take it into the Crucible, try it out for yourselves. You know, look at how much damage this thing does. Look at the impact of it. Look at the critical damage it does on a boss, you know? Like, that's as much as I could really say about it, is that this gun is a beast. I did not like it at first. You know, I definitely have to say I did not like this gun. I liked the way it looked awesome. It dropped for me. First time doing the raid, dropped for me. I'm like, oh, shit. It had a badass name. Come on, the Black Hammer. like that's the probably the one of the most badass names ever. But you know what? I didn't think it was gonna live up to its name, but you know what? It does live up to its name. It's definitely worthy of being called the Black Hammer. I could say that much about this sniper rifle. But in this gameplay, you're gonna see me use everything. You're gonna see me use an upgraded LMG and stuff. I'm pretty sure I'm probably using it right about now if it's synced up correctly. But yeah, the gameplay, it speaks for itself. You know, the gun speaks for itself. I hope you guys enjoyed this little review. I hope I cleared up a little bit of things, maybe a little discrepancies anybody was having with this gun. Maybe if anybody told you anything, or maybe if you thought something. Maybe you have the gun and you didn't even use it because it said 3 in the magazine. But I'm telling you guys to pick it up, start playing with it. Amazing gun. Best damage ever, honestly. No other sniper does the damage that this gun does. But anyways, you guys, I hope you guys have a great day. I hope you guys have fun playing the Iron Banner. And if you're not, you better get your butts in there, start playing it. But anyways, this has been the ViJaPlayer, and I'll see you guys in the next one. I'm out. Peace.
Heavy ammo inbound. Heavy ammo available. Zone A neutralized. Zone A secure. Your strategy's working. Maintain control. Zone A lost. Enemy captured Zone A. You're crushing them. Send them home crying. Heavy ammo on the way. Hard-fought victory, Guardians.